5 degrees away to clear the way for Falcon 9's launch. At this point in the countdown, both the first and second stages are nearly fully loaded with 1 million pounds of kerosene fuel and liquid oxygen. The first stage and second stage should finish loading liquid oxygen.
Stage 1, LOX load is complete.
And there you just heard, the first stage has finished LOX loading. Liquid oxygen loading for the first stage is the final propellant load for the booster. The tanks are also pressurized using helium, which is chilled so that it stays compatible with the cryogenic plumbing. During flight, that pressurization helps force propellant into the engines as the tanks empty. At T-minus 60 seconds, Falcon 9 will enter startup. At that point, the rocket's onboard flight computers will take over, and from there on out, the countdown will be fully autonomous. Just inside of T-minus 2 seconds, the 9 Merlin 1D engines will ignite, and once they're at full power, Falcon 9 will lift off the pad and begin its climb to orbit. After that engine start, the Falcon vehicles are held down until all vehicle systems are verified as functioning normally before we release for liftoff.
Stage 2, LOX load is complete.
And liquid oxygen for the second stage is now fully loaded, completing prop load for the upper stage. You can see white condensation clouds starting to vent from the rocket. As the liquid oxygen warms slightly inside the tanks, some of it will boil off, and that gas is vented to manage pressure. When the vented oxygen hits the warm, humid outside air, it will instantly condense into clouds, which is the same principle as your breath on a cold morning.
Current gas closeouts.
Standing by now for confirmation that Falcon 9 is in startup at the T-minus 1 minute mark.
Falcon 9 is in startup.
As you just heard, the autonomous flight computers have taken over the launch countdown, and stages 1 and 2 are pressurizing for launch.
Go for launch.
We just heard the launch director give the final go. With that, let's listen in to the countdown.
T-minus 30 seconds. T-minus 15 seconds. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition. And liftoff. Go Falcon, go SpainSat and G2.
Vehicles pitching downrange.
MOD chamber pressure is nominal.
As you can see, Falcon 9 has lifted off from Space Launch Complex 40 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida. The Falcon flight computer will now begin throttling down engines in preparation for max Q, or maximum aerodynamic pressure.
Power and telemetry nominal.
Good call out there for a nominal state of the vehicle.
Vehicle is supersonic. Max Q.
As you just heard, we've just passed through max Q. Again, that is the maximum aerodynamic pressure the vehicle will experience. In order to achieve orbit and avoid being pulled back to Earth, the Falcon 9 rocket needs to reach a velocity of roughly 17,500 miles per hour, horizontally. To assist with this, the first stage performs a gravity turn, initiated by a pitchover maneuver just 10 seconds into flight. This is also, the engines gimbal a small amount for about 5 seconds, slowly turning the first stage into an angled trajectory. This angled trajectory combined with...